seriously freaking me out, honey. This is your wedding dress. Excuse me, this is your bloody wedding dress. You're up and you disappear, and then I find you here doing this? What the hell is going on, Connie? I have repeatedly asked you not to call me Connie.
All right, I need an explanation right now.
It's not rocket science, Liv. I came here last night. It was an upsetting night, and I came here to put it behind me.
Behind you? Or all over you? How is wearing a reminder of the worst possible day of your life going to make any of this less unpleasant?
Well, I have a magazine to run, Liv. All right, so I came here and,
honey, how is this going to help anything?
Because the person who designed my wedding dress is very big right now, and Crimson's doing a bridal issue. It would be in our best interest to use her.
Okay.
Okay, so I put it on to see if I could do it. And I can, considering all that I've been through and everything that's happened, especially last night.
Sonny was shot last night. Again.
I know that.
Right? Scary, but hardly surprising at this point. Certainly not enough to warrant this. So what aren't you telling me? No way.
Hey, stop poking through my things. You're as bad as you were in high school.
Yeah, so is this perfume. They still make that?
You can go now.
Okay, no, seriously, honey. All kidding and insults aside, I was really worried about you. So was Steve.
For no reason.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, why aren't you with your boyfriend right now? Sonny gets shot and you go to work?
He's not my boyfriend anymore. Sonny and I are over. I thought I could handle it. I thought I could be with Sonny and it'd be different this time, but I sure was wrong.
Sonny is Sonny. He always has been. You always knew that.
People can change, Liv.
On the outside, maybe.
What is that supposed to
mean? It means you changed your name. You got yourself some stylish new clothes, but you didn't erase Connie's history or her memories or her essence. That person is still living inside you. And the same is true for Sonny.
I asked Sonny to choose between me and his vendetta against Anthony.
Nah, that may have been what you said. I can guarantee you what he heard was being asked to choose between you and his kid.
Guess who won?
Did he actually say that?
No, he didn't have to. I said it for him. I told him it was over.
Hey, look, Dante could have been killed last night. All right, I may not like the way that Sonny chooses to protect his kids, but if it keeps my son alive, I ain't gonna be the one to judge.
I always knew you should have ended up with him.
All right, you know what? I'm not going to have this conversation with you anymore. If you can't handle Sonny's life after all, you were smart to get out.